students, so this is Krishna, Geology. So now we have to discuss about the topic is gametogenesis. So in previous classes we discussed about the male and female reproductive system, and our continuation topic is gametogenesis in second year. So now we discuss about the gametogenesis. So what is mean gametogenesis? So the gametogenesis means process of formation of gametes is called as gametogenesis. Process of formation of mature male and female gametes is called as gametogenesis. So we know the gametes are two types. Number one, male gamete, and another one, female gamete. So the male gamete and the female gamete. The male gamete production is called as spermatogenesis. Spermatogenesis. And another one, so the process of formation of female gamete is called as oogenesis. Oogenesis. So once again, the formation of male gametes is called as spermatogenesis, and in female is called as oogenesis. So in this topic we discuss about the only spermatogenesis in the male. So we know the spermatogenesis takes place in testes. So already we discussed about previous classes. So the spermatogenesis takes place in testes, in the seminiferous tubule, testes. So the spermatogenesis in the male started at the puberty stage. So the puberty stage means approximately 13 to 14 years. So during this period, so in the testes, within the seminiferous tubule, so the spermatogenesis is started. So this process, first, the seminiferous tubules, so during the puberty stage, having the spermatogonial mother cells, spermatogonial stem cells. So these spermatogonial stem cells, which is present in the seminiferous tubules. So the seminiferous tubules having the spermatogonia. These spermatogonia, so after do many mitotic divisions, so the result is increase in the numbers. So we have to see, so this is the spermatogonia stem cell single. So first it is divided into two, later four. So these spermatogonia mother cells doing repeated mitotic division, increase in numbers. We have observed this diagram. Later, these spermatogonia having the diploid position and also having the 46 chromosome. Diploid position means having the set of chromosomes, two sets of chromosomes and the 46 chromosomes. So it's like a normal body cells. So later, these spermatogonia mother cells develops into the primary spermatocytes. So this is the primary spermatocytes. These primary spermatocytes, so doing so repeated meiotic divisions. So the first primary spermatocytes doing first mitotic division produced two equal sized haploid secondary spermatocytes are formed. Primary spermatocytes doing first meiotic division here form two equal sized haploid secondary spermatocytes are formed. Haploid means single set of chromosome, X or Y, single set of chromosome and having the 23 chromosomes. So this reduction cleavage, so this is the division is reduction division, so it is convert into haploid of chromosomes. So later these secondary spermatocytes complete second meiotic division. So here produced four spermatids. So this is called spermatids. Later, these spermatids undergoes to spermatozoa. Spermatozoa. So this process is called as spermatogenesis. So the spermatogonial mother cells produced spermatozoa. This process is called spermatogenesis. So the spermatozoa formed from the spermatid. This process is called as spermatogenesis. So later, after the spermatozoa released from the seminiferous tubule into the Sertoli cells. So when releasing the spermatozoa, so the spermatozoa head embedded within the Sertoli cells for the nutrition. So finally, it is entered to the vasa efferentia. So this is about the process of spermatogenesis. Now, hormonal regulation on the spermatozoa. Hormonal regulations on spermatogenesis. So the spermatogenesis started at puberty stage. So the puberty stage, this is depending on secretion of hormones. So that hormone is GnRH hormone. The GnRH hormone means gonadotropin releasing hormone. Gonadotropin releasing hormone. Here, gonadotropin releasing hormone, this is hypothalamic hormone, hypothalamus. Hypothalamus is part of the brain. So for example, this is the brain of human brain. So this part is hypothalamus. So having the gonadotropin hormone. So this is hypothalamus produces the gonadotropin hormone. Well, increasing the levels of GnRH hormone that is act on the pituitary gland. So adenoapoiesis of the pituitary gland. So for example, this is the pituitary having the two lobes. One lobe is called adenoapoiesis, and another one neuroapoiesis. The GnRH hormone increased level, that is act on the adenoapoiesis of pituitary. So these adenoapoiesis of the pituitary and also stimulating the secretions of two hormones, so which is LH and FSH hormone. When induce the adenoapoiesis of pituitary, that is stimulating the LH and FSH hormone. LH hormone means luteinizing hormone. So luteinizing hormone act on the leading cells. When releasing the luteinizing hormone, that is act on or induced on the leading cells. So the leading cells are present in the interstitial space of the lobes. So for example, this is one lobe. This medium part is called is interstitial space having the leading cells. So these leading cells function is produce the androgens. Androgens are involved the spermatogenesis process. So this is one thing. This is about the luteinizing hormone. Next, another one, FSH hormone. FSH hormone means follicle stimulating hormone. Follicle stimulating hormone acts on the Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells in the lobes. So the Sertoli cells are secretion. secretion, Sertoli cells are secreting the some types of factor which is involved the spermatogenesis. This is about the hormonal regulation on the spermatogenesis. This is about the hormonal regulation. Next, structure of Sertoli cells. Structure of spermatozoa. Structure of spermatozoa. Spermatozoa or sperm. So here diagram is, this diagram is spermatozoa structure. The spermatozoa is microscopic structure, we can see under the electronic microscope. So the sperm, human sperm contain the composed by four parts. Number one, head. Number two, neck. Number three, middle piece. And four is tail. So first we seen the head of the spermatozoa. The center of the head having the elongated nucleus, one single haploid elongated nucleus. Above the head, here a cap like structure are seen. This is called acrosome. Acrosome. The acrosome having the various enzymes, which is acid phosphatase. Acid phosphatase and another one, hyaluronidase. And another one, protease. So these enzymes are involving the dissolve of external membranes of ovum. So for the fertilization. So for example, this is the ovum. Ovum externally composed by the various membranes. So this is the protease membranes. So the secretions of sperm. So these involving the, these dissolve the external membranes of the ovum and enter into the ovum. So this is about the enzymes, acrosome enzymes. Next, neck, and another one, middle piece. The middle piece of sperm. So having the numerous mitochondria. Mitochondrias. So the mitochondria involve the, so it is produce energy, so to the tail motility. So it is give the energy for the motility of tail. So the motility of tail is very important for the fertilization. So this is about the middle piece and the tail. So this is about the structure of spermatozoa. So during the coitus, so sexual intercourse, so one time human male ejaculating the 200 to 300 millions of sperms during the one coitus. Of these amount of sperms, at least 60% sperms are so having the normal size and the normal shape for the normal fertilization. Of these, at least 40% of sperms so doing the vigorous motility for the normal fertilization. So this is about the structure of spermatozoa.